Welcome to Money Making Conversation. I'm your host, Rashawn McDonald. It is important to understand that everybody travels a different path to success. That is because your brand is different. The challenges you face in your life are different. So stop reading other people's success stories and start writing your own. That's why I created Money Making Conversation. You can be motivated by their success when you read their stories, but they offer direction for themselves, but not for you. You have to set your own goals, your own planning, and create your own committed effort. My next guest is Barbara Furlow Smiles and Ernest Smiles. She is the lead strategist, global head of employment research group and diversity engagement at Facebook. Now, outside of her role at Facebook and operating Smiles Chill, Barbara's founder of BT Consulting, LLC, and co-founder of a nonprofit, Global Smiles Health, which is focused on sustainable health and providing people with the basic needs of living around the globe, one community and smile at a time. Now, Smile Shields is a family-owned and operated company founded by Barbara and her husband, muscle-bound Ernest Smiles. The Smile Shields are made to order with the categories of children, luxury, bedazzled, and name customization. Please welcome to the Money Making Conversation. Please welcome to Money Making Conversation, Ernest and Barbara Furlow Smiles. How y'all doing?
We're doing amazing, Rush. Thank you so much for having us. Mm-hmm. Like I said, man, I've been looking forward to this interview. I've been counting down the clock to this time, so I'm happy to be here, my wife and I.
Well, first of all, you know, I want to thank everybody who are challenging themselves. When I look at what you guys are doing, you challenge yourself to understand that we're in a pandemic. When you see the stock market is flying off the charts, you don't have to be the person that's been laid off or the person who's in the line saying, waiting for somebody to hand out. And I'm not saying that negatively, but we have to be smart about it, because somehow in this pandemic, when we see unemployment, we see food lines, somebody's making money. And somebody's out there going to Costco, Amazon stock is on fire, because online, just on the Cyber Monday, it was $12.7 billion in sales. On Black Friday, there was over $9 billion in sales. So there has to be a sense that there's economic positivity in play right now. So the whole concept of what you guys are doing with the Shields are right in line with what we're dealing with the pandemic. Now, tell us about how the concept came about. And I know it's the first time coming on Money Making Conversations. Please be honest about everything you've done. I'm not here to blast anything. I just want you to tell your story. It's a power couple, because Ernest, you have your shield on, and Barbara, you got your shield on. And the reason I love it, I can see your smiles. And then here's the thing about you two. Y'all tied it to your last names. That's beautiful. So Ernest, I'm gonna let Ernest talk. That's my man. He might hurt me.
I got you covered, Rush. Well, I mean, to be honest, this product, if I must expand, it was actually shot down in an MBA program. Mm-hmm. I go to Syracuse University, finishing up my last two classes, mm-hmm. and it was developed during the last semester. Mm-hmm. And I actually brought it to an MBA group and say, I have this great idea about these customized shields.
Right.
And they were like, well, that's not going to work because we have to wear a mask. I said, you don't understand what I'm saying. I have this great idea about designing customized shields for customers to have.
Right.
And it was declined.
Right.
But I said, you know what? I'm still going to make these shields.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And I'm going to prove to you that you don't have to listen to what any other group says. If you believe in it and mm-hmm. you know there's a market, just push yourself through.
Right. Now, because I love that. And Barbara, I know you want to comment on that, because that's somebody told him no. You know what I'm saying? And quite frankly, I don't think he hears that word.
Right. Never.
So tell us about the whole process of, you know, because it's trademark and we know and all that stuff. And so talk about the process of developing a product.
Yes. So Ernest came home like he normally does with a brilliant idea. That's what we do. We support each other.
Right, right.
And the first initial shield was a Dodger shield.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So you see this, you see the makeup and the flyness, right?
Right, right, right.
So
right.
I was like, we got to take it to another level.
Right.
So one of the things we initially thought of was creating different collections. So you
right.
see here, bling around the shield, bedazzled, we have luxury, etc.
Now this is made to order, right? I mean, I can contact you and it's made to order, correct?
Yeah, so we have a website.
Okay. Now, I'm gonna help some people, because like some of this plays back on podcast too. So it's audio only. Of course, it plays off on video and on YouTube. Now, there's two things. She has the shield, and on the outside of the shield, it says smile. And then inside, there's a band that holds the shield in place. They've strategically allowed you to put a logo branding on that as well. Who came up with that idea? The double brand logo. That's double branding.
Yep. Can you hear me, Rush?
I can hear you now. Okay, cool. Now, who came up with the idea of the double shield branding, the double branding of the logos?
Oh, I did. What I thought about was, and when I saw the first Dodger one, I said, I'm going to take this back to Detroit, Michigan.
Right.
And I'm going to explain, I'm from Detroit. We used to wear name belt buckles.
Right.
And I said, man, I bet people would love to have a face shield just like the buckle.
Right.
So if you look at the black band, it's right. Nothing but a belt with your name on it.
Right.
And I
right.
just took it back to that time. Mm-hmm. And I said, we went crazy for these.
Right.
I said, I know this will work in 2020 mm-hmm. on a face shield.
Right.
And this is what you see with both what we both have on at the present moment.
Okay, cool. Now I'm gonna ask you this: the process of making a customized. What is it a number of hours? Is it a number of days? For instance, let me just take for instance the shield that you have. I'm looking at two different shields, because on your shield, Barbara, you have bedazzled around the trim. You have a bedazzled trim. Okay. Now, Ernest, on your shield, it's clean. It's a very clear screen. You can see their eyes, their nose, beautiful smiles, and which I miss with masks. I miss that, because I like to encourage people with a smile that, guess what? We're into this together. We're going to get through this together. When you wear a mask, you can't do that. Okay. But a shield allows you to smile at the person, say hello, you know, look upbeat when you're going in the grocery store, look upbeat when you come out of Home Depot. Life is not that bad. You know, I'm not mad at white people. White people shouldn't be mad at me. Black lives do
yes.
matter. You know, all this is important in the world that we live in now, when you see so much anger, so much hate, so much doubt, people afraid of so much bad media that's put in social media, that's put in the digital world. So with that said, the non-bedazzle, how long does it take trim, and how long does it take to do the bedazzle trim, Barbara?
Yeah, so it takes pretty much 48 hours for
wow.
each shield to be made.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now let's make sure we get that fully correct.
Yeah.
That's okay. Per like orders of 20 and 30.
Okay. Cool.
We can make one or more of these shields in approximately, honestly, if I call right now and say, make me a money making conversation, I get you one in 30 minutes.
See, where my staff at? See, that's what I got to do. I got to give me a money making conversation so I can just
I need to have that. Wait till I make that shield.
Because you know I'm going to put it on social media. You know, I'm letting all my million followers know about this. Because
yes.
first of all,
yeah,
you're entrepreneurs. Now, okay, Ernest, what do you do with your 40-hour week or your entrepreneurial side other than the shields? And also, I'm going to ask you that because I want to let everybody know that I always tell people, if you want to be successful, take that 24 hours that you get every day. Learn to take advantage of every hour. It seems that you guys follow that motto.
Well, let me say first, Rush, that there is no 40-hour week for us.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. There really is. Our week runs congruent, meaning they all blend. All the days blend together. We work off of goals, meaning, you know, the days just are there to set our goals. And what we do is, we live off of what is the goal for the week. Meaning, if my goal is something that requires me to work another 12 hours, I'm working the whole 12 hours.
Right.
So there's no such thing as at the 8-hour mark, I'm shutting it down at 4 o'clock.
Right.
I wake up at 3 a.m. and say, I still got some emails to send. I'm sending my emails.
Right.
So
right.
I base my week off of task.
Right.
Not off of the day. So
right. mm-hmm.
when you understand as an entrepreneur, there should never be an 8 to 4 set clock.
Yes.
Because then that would mean you just limited yourself. And if Rush called for money making conversations and want you to come on the show, you say, "Hey, Rush, I can't make it because I'm off at 4 o'clock."
Right. You're right. You know,
so, right. Well, Rush called me. Rush need me at 2 a.m. on the show. I'm getting on the show.
Well, that's what I like about you, sir. Thank you very much. Now, Barbara, I know I got Hercules over there to you, right? You know, Hercules over there. You know, he got, but you know, something, here's the deal, because when you came on, before she came, she was energized. You know, he was up. I said, oh, I'm ready for this interview. And now I see, you know, you're married to the Energizer Bunny, okay? Right. You can't come home and not be happy to see each other. And that's important because, you know, God has blessed y'all with a clear understanding that why produce a sad day when a happy day is better. Okay. Mm-hmm. And so now the bedazzle one, that bedazzle trim that you put down, what is that trim made of, or what is creating that bedazzleness?
Yeah. So it's called, when you go on our website, you can add this to any shield. It's called Bling Around the Shield.
Look at that.
And so really
that's
what it
Detroit.
Is.
That's Detroit. Where are you from, Barbara? What city are you from? He said he's from Detroit. Where are you from?
I'm from Los Angeles, so they call me Hollywood.
Oh.
So you see, that's why you got the bling. Come on, Rush.
No.
You got the bling in Hollywood together. This is what the product is.
I got the Motor City. I got Hollywood. No. See, he know I've been in Detroit many times. Me and Steve Harvey used to go up there and do comedy shows and all that stuff up at the Fox Theater. So I know about dressing. So when he starts talking about Detroit, I know exactly what he's talking about. I lived in L.A. for 15 years, so I know exactly what you're talking about with bling. So I got a strong mix of both of y'all conversation. Now, when you started introducing the brand, okay, of course, like you said, the NBA thought this wasn't a good idea. How did you start introducing it on social media? Did you shoot videos? How did you guys start introducing the brand?
Yes, I'll take that. I actually work at Facebook and Instagram, the number one social media company. And what we see in particular on COVID-19, talk about the pivot.
Right.
So we pivoted to purely social media e-commerce.
Mm-hmm.
And we utilize our social media platform. We have amazing photographer and designers where we took some shots of people in the shield, and we created organically the following on Instagram. What we also did, I'm also getting my MBA at UCLA. I want to shout that out. So he's not the only MBA in the house. And what we did was we bypassed all the traditional ways and go to market, right? So you have your market analysis, it takes years. And we said, why don't we try the social media out? And so we had the direct to consumer interaction with our customers, mm-hmm. that let us know that we were onto something. Mm-hmm. And Rush, I wanted to also mention, you talked about being trademarked. So one of the early signs that this was going to be successful is when we were in the process of getting trademarked, there were over 10,000 applications for masks and shields.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But when you talked about other people making money, mm-hmm. you know, many people saw this as an opportunity, and many people that don't look like us.
Absolutely. And I agree. And I can see, you know, that's what I'm happy about, because I have some friends, you know, they've been very successful with masks. Okay. And I've helped them and dropped their information in my newsletter and dropped it on my social media, because that's why I created Money Making Conversations. And so when I look at African Americans, clearly understanding the pivot, clearly understanding that, and this is why I'm excited about it. And this is because of the fact that there's a vaccine coming out, and Black people don't want to take it. They don't trust the system. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And so I think it's time that, in order for us to create trust, we got to move you guys face to the front of the line. You know what I'm saying? It's more than just me taking a photo with myself on it. I want to take a photo with you two to post on social media, talking about it's a Black couple that have invented, you know, these shields, and you can buy from them online. So that's way more important than anything.
Because that's
going to encourage Black participation, Blacks to say, I'll support it. Blacks may even take the vaccine. Because we understand that we don't want to be guinea pigs.
Right.
But then also we want to be able to participate in the support system of profitability. And that's what you guys are doing with the shield. Look, it's a health, it's for health, it's for safety, COVID-19 safety, allows you to create social distance. To me, it creates a better social experience. to me. I think that in the end, let's go and be honest, you can still eat. You can still do put a straw. You can do a lot of things with this shield here. And that's what you kid. So all that was taken in consideration, Ernest, when you really started thinking about this whole process, huh?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. We thought about, like you said, the social experience, and that, like you said, we're going to be going through COVID in and out for the next couple of years.
Yes.
So we recognize that. And our goal as entrepreneurs was to embrace it, not to act as if it didn't exist, or to go into a shell of fear. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to be honest, my wife and I, we did go through an initial phase of fear. And I want the audience to know that fear is okay.
Yes.
In the beginning.
Yes.
But you got a short time. I have a window of fear. Mm-hmm. And that's probably 2 weeks to figure out how scared I'm going to be.
Right.
And after that, I got to come out of there with a plan.
Right.
You know, and my wife developed, and Garrett Webster from South Africa, the 4 F's. You want to tell them about the 4 F's?
Yeah. So we talk about the silent fear where Ernest was talking about. But the other 4 F's that we talk about is focus.
Mm-hmm.
Focus. Once you get out of the fear, focus on how do you lean in.
Mm-hmm.
And answer the call on what you're in, right?
Mm-hmm.
How do you lean into and meet the moment where it is? And then the faith, whatever anybody mm-hmm. practices, there's some faith that you have to know that you're going to get through this. There's some faith to know that you will have the answers and that you can prosper. We have a win-win mentality of prosperity and abundance.
Right.
And so we were speaking out. We were a money magnet. We're an opportunity magnet. A lot of people were like, F 2020. We did not speak
Never
that
said
into the universe because we knew that 2020 was going to be prosperous for us.
Mm-hmm.
And then we talked about family. So we're mm-hmm. a family-owned business. We knew that we had to stick together during this tumultuous time.
Right.
And why not use this opportunity to build something beautiful together? And the last piece is future. What's mm-hmm. our future outlook of this? So to be quite honest with you, we've only been in business with SmileShift for 4 months
mm-hmm.
and we've seen the Uber growth. And so when you talk about the future of it, we started to attract like-minded mm-hmm. individuals and do mm-hmm. partnerships. So mm-hmm. we're partnering with Sydney Jackson,
mm-hmm.
who has mm-hmm. a pageant beauty line. We're also partnering
Miss Teen USA. Let's mention who she is.
She's Miss Teen DC USA, Sydney Jackson, with her pageant beauty line. Mm-hmm. We're also partnering with Shamia. From Atlanta Housewives, mm-hmm. who's going to come out with a mask and shield combination.
Absolutely.
Which is exciting. And then an Instagram influencer, Tori Hardy, who's also coming out with a shield and mask. So we were in the beginning, we saw this opportunity. And there are a lot of people that are now understanding that we're going to be in this for some time.
Well, that's why I wanted to help promote YouTube. You know what I'm saying? You know, because I can easily put that shield on my face, money making conversation. And I want that. Don't get me wrong. But also, like last week, a couple of weeks ago, I had a couple that were HBCU grad. They created a Clarence Claus.
Nice.
And I posted the picture of them two and their two children. Blew up. You know, they created Clarence Claus. And so I know the value of support when African Americans know that they are creating this product that they can support. It's not somebody modeling a product. And that's what I would be. Right. I'll be modeling a product that they wouldn't know where it was, who created it. And so I want you guys to take a real nice photo. I probably already got it.
We do.
I was just trying to be professional. You know,
we said it to you, Rush. We got you.
Hey, go right there. You know, get it to Samantha. And so let's get it up. Let's build y'all brand. Let's build this brand. I've created Money Making Conversation. It ain't about me making money. It's about me sharing your stories, about giving you a platform that's free, that I've been blessed with to be able to have interviews. You guys been trusting me to tell your story, to share your story to my fan base. And in the end, the title of my show is Money Making Conversation. So if you come on my show, make a little money, then guess what? The conversation is real good.
And that's what we like. We love the partnership.
Well, just like I said, this is not even a partnership. Their partnership is you came on the show. You've done your job. Our relationship is about me just showing you some tricks of marketing and branding, using the tentacles that I put out there and I've created. And also, but I want to market you too, okay?
Mm-hmm.
On my platform with a link to click to buy. your product, and that's what I want to do. I do it on my Facebook page. I got nearly 800,000 followers on my Facebook page. I want to put you guys on Monday, on a Monday post before Christmas. So we want to turn this around real quick.
Okay, man, Rush.
My man Adele. He's my program director. Samantha is my executive producer of Money Making Conversation. So we're going to get this together. But more importantly, it's not so much what you do outside your brand, because again, Ernest, you explained, look, you're entrepreneurs, okay? You're not 8 to 5. You're dreamers with a goal and a purpose. And I just noticed, you know, underneath that shield, you got a little cold turtleneck on there. Ernest, I just noticed you got a turtle. Boy, I'm so mad at you. You know what? I'm about to take this cover. What brand of turtleneck is that, man?
This is Hugo Boss, man. This is one of my go-tos.
I'm a
Hugo Boss kind of guy, man. I just didn't put the jacket. I didn't want to overdo it, but I got the Hugo Boss jacket to go on top of this.
This is
it right here.
Oh. Because, you know, I love turtlenecks, man. I love...
That's one of my favorites.
Because the mask... See, that's where he got the mask on. So I can look through the mask. I kept looking through the mask. I said, does he have a turtleneck on?
We got it.
See, that's the cool thing about it. He modeling. He just showed me. He can flip. I didn't know you could do that.
Hey, man, I like Showtime, man. We're in LA right now.
What he just showed me, he can flip the face up. See, a lot of people, they don't do that. They have to take the entire shield off their face and put it down.
We flip this up right here.
See, that's all standard.
We can sit them up there for a minute, have a conversation or sip or have a little food, right? And everything will be great.
And make emergency, drop it back down. Somebody come by coughing or looking crazy.
Yeah, put it back down. Put that shield back up, baby. 6 feet. Get back.
Absolutely. So tell everybody again, Barbara, you know, how they can reach you guys through social, through your website. So we can get this. And again, like I said, we're going to get everything else timed onto my social media and let your blackness shine on my social media, okay?
I appreciate that. Our IG is Smiles, so SMILES, Shield, SHIELD. Mm-hmm. That's our IG. And then our website is smilesshield.com, where you go in, you customize it, you bedazzle. We have some pre-made, easy, fast shipping. Customers are super happy.
Well, I'm happy. You know, the happiness, you're perfect couple for what your brand is selling. And I'm just fortunate that I was at the end of the day, y'all put a smile on my face.
Come on, man. We love that. We got a gift box coming for you too, Rush. Okay. I just want to make sure you know, I'm making you a special Rush Money Making Conversations gift box.
Okay, cool. I appreciate that, making that happen. And again, thank you for coming on Money Making Conversations. And again, get those photos before Christmas. You can go to my Facebook page, like at Rashawn McDonald. I think I got like 790,000 followers or something like that. Every Monday, I put in the PM, I put a entrepreneur or somebody on my show, and there's a motivational quote tied to them. Okay. And I want to do the same for you too. And your smile shields and brand your entrepreneurial skills that, you know, this is a Black Lives Matter from an entrepreneurial standpoint, and we're going to make it happen. Okay.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having us. I want to say you got one of the best podcast studios I ever seen. I'm feeling like I'm in a studio right now.
Hey, Ernie, this ain't the complete version. Like I said, my team know I'm going to bring y'all back in 2021. It should be ready like before Christmas, but I'm gonna bring y'all back so we can talk about first of the year when they get those vaccines out there. Because like I said, we're gonna do some stuff, because if I get some contracts with the military, you know, we're gonna come back, you know, we're gonna come back with y'all.
We got it covered. We got some back in on that too, Rush. I'll talk to you about that later.
Okay, cool. We're gonna win. Y'all be careful now. Love you both, okay?
Love you, man. Thank you, brother. Appreciate you so much.
Okay, we talk soon, all right?
All right.
If you want to hear more Money Making Conversations, please go to moneymakingconversation.com. I'm Rashawn McDonald. I'm your host. Thank you.